How are y'all dickheads doing? It is I, once again, Dick Record, coming to you live from the studio in New York City. I'm about to do another premiere draft from the Outlaws of Thunder Junction, but before we get into it, if you're new to the channel and you enjoy what you see, please like, share, and subscribe, and more importantly, come over to twitch.tv/Dick Record. Link in the description where you catch streaming video games, Leathercraft, and other sort of nonsense from around 4 to around 8 Eastern Standard Time, but with that out of the way, hey, we're ready! Pack one, pick one, what are we getting? Alright, so there's a Great Train Heist, there's a Paladin, there's a Roadrunner, these are all good cards. Lone Shark's fine, but I don't want to first pick anything blue. I think I'll take the Train Heist. There's also a Skewer the Critics. I've won games off of this, and it's a fine removal spell. The fact that you can trigger Spectacle off of playing a Desert is great too. Great Train Heist can be an extra turn, and it's a neat combat trick. I've actually turned entire games around because of this stupid card. I was playing a game where I was about to die, my opponent swung out, and I was just like, alright, Great Train Heist, all my creatures get first strike and +1/+0, and they went from having a commanding board to, oh, I only have this mana dork left. Yeah, it could also just be an extra turn, simply because like giving all your creatures first strike, +1/+0, and creating an extra combat step at instant speed is actually amazing, especially if you have a commanding board. So we're going to take Great Train Heist. It doesn't necessarily mean that we're in that color, but I will take it. There's a Murder here. There's also a Throw from the Saddle. I think that Throw from the Saddle has a higher win rate on average. Murder's just great, but Throw from the Saddle is just, it's one of green's best commons, so I think it's worth taking here over, let's see, there's also a Scalestorm Summoner. If I want to remain in red, this is probably the best pick, actually. Unscrupulous Contractor, I like, but I don't like as much as the 3-1 that does the same thing. That, well, you don't sacrifice a creature, you just draw a card. Murder is great, too. Throw from the Saddle is great. I think we're going to take the Scalestorm Summoner, actually. Note that if you want to rely on this as an instant speed combat trick, you can't, like, cast it beforehand. Although it would be kind of nice, right? But this can help you get the massive board that you would need to then make the Great Train Heist that much more viable. So I think we could take the Scalestorm Summoner out over it, over this Throw from the Saddle, especially because I know that we're not going to see this Scalestorm Summoner again. there's a Collective Defiance. There's another Throw from the Saddle. I like both of these cards, actually. I think I want to stay in red for the time being. I know. Green's probably the better color. But I like Collective Defiance a lot. As a modal spell, sometimes you just do 3 damage to your opponent. Sometimes you just remove a creature with 4 toughness, right? Which is the same rate as Explosive Derailment. And sometimes you loot away your whole hand to try again because, like, oh no, these 2/2s are not going to do anything to that 5/4, or that 5/5. So yeah, let's take the Collective Defiance for now. For now. We don't know what our second color is yet. I know that Throw from the Saddle is a good card, though. But I like the modality of Collective Defiance. It's burn. It's removal. Ooh, there's a Gila Courser. Jesus. Alright. Let's see how long we could stay in mono red. This is a 4-power creature, so it turns on the Scalestorm Summoner. It's also a 3-drop, right? So you could play that after you play the Scalestorm Summoner. And you don't have to attack with this thing. You just attack with the Scalestorm Summoner to make the 3-1 to replace itself, essentially. And if they can't do anything about the 3-3, you get to do it again next turn. This also can get you card advantage, because until the end of your next turn, you could play that card that you exile at the top with the Gila Courser. So yeah, let's take the Gila Courser. Vantage is fine. Bloodseeker's not bad, actually. Nothing else really here. Repulse is also okay. And there's a Desert, but not in our colors. There's another Vantage. Not much here. Not much here. I'm going to take the Vantage in case we end up somehow splashing a white card, right? Because it is in one of our primary colors so far, in red. It feels like we're going to be in red. There's nothing here that I think is very, very good. I like a Mourner's Surprise in a black deck, but I feel like we can get one of those later. And Freestrider Commando's okay. It's an okay 3-drop, it's an okay 4-drop. What's really fun is when you can cheat on its mana cost. There's a Holy Cow. That's actually not bad. There's an Irascible Wolverine, which I think I like over the cow. Although the cow is evasive, I do think I like the Wolverine a little bit more. And I don't think I need to spec on a Holy Cow right now. The cow is evasive, but the Wolverine immediately gets you card advantage and you can plot it, right? So let's just take that for now. Now there's a Holy Cow. There's a Skewer. There's a Quill Charger. Quill Charger helps the Scalestorm Summoner a little bit better. The Skewer's nice. I will say that. It's burn. It's removal, right? There's also a Conduit Pylons. I'll take the Skewer for now. I know. We're drafting mono red. Take for a Ride's not great. Savage Smash kind of is, but we passed so many green cards. And I didn't really see anything particularly super nice in green, but I will take it here. Although, there's a Mirage Mesa. Yeah, let's take the Savage Smash for now. Take for a Ride is not where we want to be. I think I'd rather have a Highway Robbery over a Peddler. Although the Peddler's just a fine 2-drop, right? We can plot this, and that means it ends up being better for the late game. Let's see. Alright, so there's a green card. There's an Outlaw's Fury, which is fine. Skullduggery exists. Emergent Haunting is wheeled because people are just ignoring the blue cards almost wholesale. I think I could take the Skullduggery here. Is it better than Commando? You know what? Let's take the Commando for now. Yeah, see, nothing for us here. Jailbreak Scheme is an okay removal spell. Steer Clear is fine as well. Let's take the Jailbreak Scheme, but we're going to put that to the side for now. I'll take the Oasis Gardener. It's not great, but if we end up splashing for something silly, we're going to want the Gardener. Somebody did take the other Inspiring Vantage, which is fine. There's always like somebody who's like, I'm going to rare draft. I will take a Steer Clear now, but I don't know if we're playing it. It's a fine removal spell. It's just like, oh, is that attacking me? Is it power? Let's see, toughness 2 or less. It's your typical white combat trick that just helps you to either destroy something small that's attacking or blocking at instant speed. I do prefer it to... I'll take a reach for this guy. I do prefer it to... Oh my god, that's a final showdown! I haven't drafted this card yet, right? Yeah. It's actually just a bunch of fine combat tricks at the same time, as well as the board wipe aspect of it. Yeah, I do think it's very much the card we take here. The board wipe aspect's great, especially because you could at instant speed go like, my biggest creature survives, all of your stuff is gone. This could also help you destroy a Rakdos, because all creatures losing all abilities until end of turn is great, right? We're passing up another Scalestorm Summoner, a Prickly Pear. Honest Rutstein's also pretty good, as is the Wolverine, but I think we definitely have to take the final showdown. I'm sorry. What we got here? Annie joins up, Scorching Shot, Hypothesis for Rizzle. There's also a Dance of the Tumbleweeds. I think the smart pick is the Scorching Shot. Part of me wants to take this Dance of the Tumbleweeds or the Spinewoods Paladin. I don't really have a second color yet, right? We have a white, a red-white land, and I can take the Spinewoods Paladin. I think that would be just like a fine 4/5 drop, and we could take Dance, and that's just a fine 5/6/3 drop, which I really like about this card. I think I'm gonna... God, this is hard. The Spinewoods Paladin also helps us to stabilize, and it can be a legitimate win condition. Dance of the Tumbleweeds can also be a legitimate win condition. This is hard. Let's take the Dance for now. Oh, there's a Marchesa. We don't have any blue, and we don't have any black cards that matter, right? I didn't end up taking that other card. There's a Make Your Own Luck, and there's a Spinewoods Paladin. Wow. Okay, and then there's a Creosote Heath for if we end up like still playing this final showdown and end up being in green-red. I think we could take the Paladin here. I wanted it last pack. It's also an Explosive Derailment, which is not nothing, you know? It's not nothing. But I think I want to take... Well, Derailment's one of the best removal spells in red. We do have two removal spells already. I want to take this Spinewoods Paladin solely because I want to cut off green as well a little bit. So we'll take that. Betrayal at the Vault and Annie. I'm sorry, not Annie. Jolene. Nothing else here except for Betrayal. Jolene. Reckless Lackey exists. Ankle Biter. I do want to take this Jolene. I really like it. I like Jolene better than Betrayal at the Vault simply because if your opponent has any mana open, Betrayal at the Vault seems very suspect to cast. That said, when this goes off, it is a 2-for-1, and that does feel pretty good, but I will take the Jolene. Jolene can also make us treasures, which can help us to splash for other things. There is a prickly pear. Very happy to see that, actually. I think I will take the prickly pear here. Brimstone Roundup is kind of, like, on your second spell, you get one of these things. Ugh. I'll take the prickly pear. Form a posse. We could play that. I think Naturalist is probably better, though. Naturalist is a 2-3 that gets you some information and gets you a land. I think I like that, yeah. It's weird that it went so late. Bristlepack Sentry, sure. Look at all these. Actually, like, Canyon Crab and Splasher are actually playable green, blue cards, rather. And they're going so late. I'll take the Bristlepack Sentry. Just a nice 2. Wow, Gila Courser. This is a late Gila Courser. And the reason why it's a late Gila Courser is because we completely cut off red in that first pack, so everyone else just thinks that red is, like, dead. I'm going to take the Gila Courser. It's, like, very easy here. There's another Wolverine, and there's a Prickly Pear. We have a lot of threes that can get us cards, so I just think it's a good time to take a Prickly Pear, which can help us make the Scalestorm Summoner work a little bit better. I think this was the pack that also had another Scalestorm Summoner, and that just didn't wheel. Shame. The Pulverizer. I think we could take the Pulverizer just as a top end. I don't think we play it, right? Even though the Spinewoods Paladin can be a 4-drop because of the plot thing on it. And you know what's funny is if you play Pulverizer into Paladin, that's actually, like, not bad. The Explosive Derailment Wield. Okay, yeah, yeah. Red is, like, super duper open. Like, people do not want red. Here, that's fine. I'll take it. I'll take it. It feels like we're in red-green right now. Leaning more towards red. Yeah, that's a late Deadeye Duelist, and oh my god. How do I swing that? I'm gonna take it. It's my most drafted. I already have 4 of them. I'm gonna take it. We gotta figure out how to get double blue somehow. We gotta take every bit of fixing we can. There's no way that I pass that. There's no way. There's no way. There's a Cactarantula here too. There's an Aloe Alchemist. We don't pass the Bonnie Paul. Somebody might be in blue too. Just, you know, like, Bonnie Paul's like the dumbest thing you could pass. I don't think we're gonna be splashing for white now. I think we're gonna be trying real hard to fix for this Bonnet Paul. I should have taken that other Oasis Gardener. Any on color blue land? I think we have to just take. Nothing here. There's a Fling. There's a Forlorn Flats. There's an Ankle Biter. None of these are good for us. Right? Like, none of these are good for us. Pyromancers is bad. Rope Master is bad. Ankle Biter is at least playable. I will say that. Ankle Biter is at least playable. There's a Fling. Fling's kind of funny, you know? But I don't think we play it. Because you 2-for-1 yourself. It's like the worst card. I will Ankle Biter. Maybe the Forlorn Flats is just better. No. And the reason why I say that is, like, what if we're splashing for, like, this, you know what I mean? Okay. So, Outlaw Stitcher's great. Vile Smasher's fine. I don't think we have enough Outlaws in our deck with, let's see. One Assassin. And 4 mercenaries. Yeah, we don't have enough outlaws for that to matter. This is another mercenary, which also makes a mercenary. And it's probably the best card for us here. Passing up a Karavek, Vile Smasher. Whoever's in the crime deck that probably got created because that Marchesa earlier did not wheel. Gonna be eaten well, getting either a Karavek or a Vile Smasher, but we're gonna take this Prickly Pear. The Prickly Pear's a fun guy. God, this is a really good mystical. I love Mystical Tether, but Beastspawn Outcaster draws us a card, right? We could plot it, turn 2, and then just get something for it, turn 3. I think that that's fine. Cactarantula is one of those cards that I'd love one of. Maybe? This Bonnie Paul is going to be real hard to cast, isn't it? Take the Outcaster. It's a Gold Pan. There's a Demonic Ruckus. I do like Demonic Ruckus, and I like it over stuff like Deadeye Duelist. Yeah, let's take the Ruckus here. God, I really wish we had some fixing outside of What's-Her-Face. Mobile Homestead is not a bad card. We do have a fair amount of mounts, but I don't think this is going to be coming out early. We get to look at it. It's not reveal the top unless it's a land. Okay. I think I could take the Mobile Homestead. I think it's fine. Frostification number 2, just a bad card. I'll take a Bristlepack Sentry. 2-drop or nothing. We'll take the Peddler. I don't think we're playing this Bonnie. I don't think we're playing this Bonnie at all. It's okay. It's okay. I just, you know what it is? My eyes went wide when I saw that Bonnie Paul, and I was just like, damn, girl. I think we could take the, is it the Sterling Hound? We have enough creatures, right? Maybe I'll just take the Arid Archway. We're not playing this. We're not playing this. Take that for the collection. None of these are playable. I'll take that for the collection. Wow. That's a really late sheriff. Gold Pan? Not enough fixing, I don't think. I think if I want to play Bonnie Paul, I need to have, like, 4 blue sources. I don't think that's enough. I need to have, like, 4 legitimate blue sources. And I don't think we can pull that off. Whoops, wrong one. I don't think we can pull that off. Did that not? Oh. Alright, so. Removal. Oh, wow. I ended up not taking that much removal, did I? Alright. Demonic Ruckus, I love. Okay, so Derailment's also removal. No, Derailment, get into this pile here. Train Heist is a nice combat trick. So let's see, what's my worst creatures? Clearly it's the Duelist. Love those guys. Love this guy. Love that guy. Love that guy. Free Strider Commando might not make it. Patient Naturalist. We don't really get much graveyard value, but it does basically draw us a card. It is telling me to play... Alright, so Arid Archway. Sorry, we don't need you. It is telling me to play 3 Islands. And we have the Gardener. And it's saying that that might be fine for Bonnie Paul. Let's cut a 3. Right. Demonic Ruckus. Robbery. Dance of the Tumbleweeds. Dance of the Tumbleweeds can help us fix for Bonnie Paul. Gold Pen is there. We need to cut creatures then, right? Alright, so let's cut an Ankle Biter. We don't have that many fight spells. We didn't get too many... Throw from the Saddles. We didn't get any. We got Smash, and we got these other, like, damage-based ones. Everything is damage-based. How are we doing on creatures? We have 17 creatures. I'm gonna cut the Homestead, and Dance is a creature, and Ramp, and Fixing. But I think we need these. Let's see. Are we turning on the Sentry? You know what? I think we need the Sentry solely because we need to put up that wall early on that trades with other things. So we're going to leave those alone. Gardener's fine. We don't have any 4s, do we? Wow. All right, so Spinewood's Paladin is our 4. We do want to hit all of our land drops. Let's cut the Gold Pan. I don't think it's going to... Oh, actually, the Gold Pan might be fine in this deck because we have a few creatures that... Pulverizer's still in here. I think I can cut the Pulverizer. I don't think that that's good enough. But the Pan might be, so I'm gonna go put that back in, actually. And we're gonna cut this Robbery. Right. The wrong button, sorry. I'm gonna put the Gold Pan back in there. Not because it makes a treasure, but because it does turn on a few things like the sentries, the Scalestorm Summoners, right? Yeah, I think that that's fine. Alright, so, how are we doing on lands? Suggest lands. Is that fine? I wish we had better fixing than that. 7, 7, and 3. Yeah, Bonnie Paul is a splash because I just couldn't say no to her, you know? Oh no, going into round 1. We'll see how it goes. If I feel too mana choked, I will cut her from the deck. Cause she's wonderful top end, right? But she is the splash. We have 2 additional pieces of fixing with the Gardener and the Dance of the Tumbleweed. So I think we're okay. We actually technically have 5 sources because of that. This is great. Keep it. We're going first. Gold pan on 2. I think Wolverine on 3, right? Oh, that's even betterer. Bristlepack Sentry. Mm-hmm. Stable Master. Opponents. If I play this, I could just attack with the Sentry. Let's just plot that and try to build out a board a little bit more. Because if we hit a land with Irascible Wolverine. Ooh, there's a Beav. Alright. Play that. There's a... Well, can't play that. Oh, we can, can't we? I don't know. Green, green. Make a treasure. Play that. 4 to target creature. Done. Auto pay. Because that's gone regardless. So, and I'd rather just get rid of the 4 drop. Or the 4-4. Right? They ramped into it. Plus, they didn't make a land drop last turn. You know? I'd rather them not have that 4-4 with vigilance. Luxurious Locomotive. Alright. You know what we could do here is destroy that and kill that? Creature. Auto pay. And then just hit them with the Wolverine. And I destroy that mainly because, well, one, I don't want them to have a 6-5 that's also going to be getting them mana. Two, they needed that mana dork. They were living off that mana dork. We're on the beatdown play. This mercenary can make one of these sentries a 4-3, so everything gets to attack next turn. They have the varmint. They can pop. Oh, are you doing it? You doing it? You doing it? Come on, do it.
Do it, come on!
Aww. That's actually really good here. I'm gonna make that a little bit bigger. That way they can't, in response. They can activate that in response. So this actually is probably better because we just trade this way. Aww. I was going to get a blue source and make a 6-6, or 7-7 rather. Hey, the beatdown plan worked. It worked. You know, sometimes you got to be fast, especially if your opponent stumbles on mana. That was pretty good. 1-0 going into round 2. Alright. Here's our next opponent. Alright, we got all the mana we need. We can plot that turn 2, turn 3, play Jolene. I think this is great, actually. This is a definite keep. Opponent's big think on this opener. So, yeah. Sure. They're blue-red. Okay, they have Duelist, De La Mind. Plot that. Malcolm, the Eyes. Okay. I think they just hit, yep. What was that hesitation? Alright, play this. Can't really do anything about that. They could shrink her in response, but I guess I'm getting a card regardless. Alright. Wow. Rude. Okay. So that does shrink her to an 0-2. Not that we're blocking. But that does add additional pressure in the sky. Yep. Okay. Let's see. What is this? 2 and a red. So we can give our creatures first strike. if we really want to. Let's play a... Let's not play a land first. Let's just attack. Because if they have something tricksy here... Yep, making a treasure token. We can either explosive derailment in response, or... Okay, so they're taking it. Bong, bong. Alright, play land. Let's just play the sentry for now. And end our turn there. Because this will allow us to, if we really need to, and we do have the double blue for what's her fucking face. We can blow up one of these creatures. Sure. Gone, gone, gone. My turn. Oh, there's a red source. Alright, let's see. We could activate this for... Oh, we can not full send it, but we can do two of the three things, so yeah. Oh, we're making another treasure here. Sure. Gong, gong, gong. Opponent is... I don't know, I don't think we could have won just right there. So I'm just gonna play this out. Yep. And enter in there. We have a nice 4-2 that blocks this thing pretty well. Alright, good game. 2-0. Too much pressure from the green-red deck. Right? This gold pan always feels like it's not bad, actually. I'm gonna say that right now. It feels like it's not bad. If we didn't have the Jolene or the Gila Courser, we could just pop this out, put it on the sentry. It gets us a treasure too, so like, you know. If we're ever stumbling on mana, we did have a second blue source. So if we top deck Jolene, that would have been fantastic. Cause then we have a reach creature too. Holding back explosive derailment never felt bad either. Yeah. Yeah. The cards are seem to be doing great actually. And we're drawing well, we're drawing to our curve. We don't need no stinking Jolene, right? 2-0 going into round three so far. One of the decks of all time. No. it's not bad so far. All right, here's our next opponent. I did consider activating Train Heist to go and double turn there, but I decided against it. There's the Bonnie Paul. We are going first, so knowing that the Bonnie Paul's in our hand, I think we're going to keep this for the time being. We can plot out the Wolverine, right? Especially because our opponent's not really doing anything here. Although, is it better to just get on the board with the Summoner or the Prickly Pear? No, our opponent hasn't done anything. Let's just do this for now. We want to hit a fourth land. If we hit a fourth land, we can Spinewoods Paladin, right? Yep, sure. Drover Grizzly. Okay. There's a smash. It's not a land, but I will take it. See, this as a 3-3 never feels great, you know what I mean? Usually they give you the option to plot, but I think plot is only from your hand. Yeah. Oh, maybe it's not. I don't know. We did miss a land drop, which feels bad here. Feels pretty bad. Sterling Keykeeper, sure. There's a land. All right. I think we just send. Because they're not blocking. Yep. Cool. If they have a combat trick, we're getting that out of their hand, and I don't mind that, actually. Sure. That's going to hit us for 5 next turn. We can't necessarily skewer here. Yeah, it was probably better that we did attack into that because we got that out of their hand. And... we'll pop that. They did gain 5 off of that, but they're probably going to want this Spinewoods Paladin off the board. Sure. Oh, we can kill that now. Perfect. Play this. Creature I control, creature I don't control. Kill that. And end my turn, I guess. I thought I had one more mana, but that's right, we missed the land drop. Okay. These can trade. Oh, they have a fight spell here. Not wonderful. Let's see. Okay, land, perfect. Prickly pear. They have another take up the shield. That pauses because they have another take up the shield. That blocks. Sure. Alright. Tap this, make this slightly bigger. Cast this. Draw a card. Yep. Next. I'll attack, make a 3-1. Yep. Gong, gong. Gila Courser. End turn. Now I don't have to necessarily pump that thing. I could pump up the Gila Courser and attack into this if they want to hold, leave this back for Bloxies. It does feel like they have another take up the shield though. Into the Tumbleweeds. Pretty bad for us, actually. That's gonna make a 7-7? Yeah, it is. Alright. Yep. They got their Bucolic Ranch. They still have access to 2 mana here, too. Okay. I'm gonna attack with this, actually. If they block with the 7-7, I can skewer it after. And I think that's the only way we can get the 7-7 off the board. Oh, I forgot to mount it. I'm so dumb. I played like I knew that they had that too. We're very far from playing the Bonnie Paul, so I'm just gonna pitch it. Yep, okay. Great Train Heist is great here. I think that could win us the game, actually. Let's see. +1/+0 and first strike to everything. Bristly Bill, sure. I want them to hit me with this thing. I'll block with the 2/2. Pack Tarantula. Alright. Okay. Is this a full send? Is this a full send turn? I think we tick this up. Actually, not that, because it's not going to get big enough. I attack with these three. What are their blocks? These aren't good blocks. Never mind. If I attack with this, I can kill something unless they block with... No, that's not good either. No attacks. Ugh! And... Here. Have a sentry. End turn. Oh, no! We're getting out big creatured. Yep. And then the Bristly Bill being there, sure. The Bristly Bill's a problem. Pass. My turn. Land is fine here. Create a tap treasure token. I don't think we get through there. I don't think we get through their creatures. Right? If I make this a 3-4, I guess I get attacked with everything. But that's a 7-6. These two eat something. This probably eats something. Right? They block 4 creatures. 1, 2. You know what? This is basically YOLO here. Create a 3-1. And if they don't block, they might just be dead. Yeah. That goes in front of that. That goes in front of that. Yeah. Okay. I could pay, right? Choose target opponent. Auto pay. They don't have anything else, so. But we do lose a few creatures. They're going to take some DiMaggio, right? And the creatures that do live are going to have a difficult time blocking what's left. So, we get to double send it, essentially. Yep. Okay. Sure. Few tokens. Okay. Then if I send everything again, no, we have to actually take, I don't know, what am I doing? Oh, I can't activate that again. All right, so I'll attack again. I don't think they take any of the blocks that are bad for them, but yep. Okay. Puts him at 2. We have access to 5. Yep. Yeah, the Bonnie Paul would have been great there. Now that we have 5 like mana and everything, right? Bonnie Paul would have been great there. But I don't think we can attack through this board. We tried. I don't think anything would have saved us either. Ancient Naturalist. Okay. That gets them a treasure. Because they milled. Yep. And I'm dead. So, wait, hold on. Good game. They should have just attacked. Okay. Maybe we needed to keep the Bonnie Paw. No. We were so far away from casting that Bonnie Paw that it's better off in the yard and getting us another card. It dug us one closer to our, what's it called? Should we have done it a turn earlier, though? Bristly Bill wouldn't have been around? Oh no, he was around. They wouldn't have put another token on something, but everything else had tokens on them, except for... Oh no, it was just 2 of the creatures. Oh well. Sometimes you can't attack through the biggest creatures. I still feel like that Great Train Heist was great there. Alright, let's see. Here's 2 Gila courses and a Great Train Heist. Yeah, that's fine. A 2-drop, like a Bristlepack Sentry, would actually be great here. Yep. Dinging us. Look at that. We can play a Gila Courser into a... Sure. Where were you a turn earlier, sir? Where were you a turn earlier? I think we plot this Free Strider Commando. Next turn. Sure. Vault Buster. You know what? Let's just play the Outcaster and play the Sentry. Oh, I can plot the out. No, I can't do both. Let's just draw a card off of this. Yep. Play that. And I guess if I saddle, they still lose something, right? And we get a Demonic Ruku, which is going to be fun next turn. Plus it digs us closer to another land. They would have to double block if they want this to trade. I guess not. All right. And they're like, I guess they think their Slickshot Vault Buster is that much better. I don't know. They do get free attacks here, so if they can commit a crime, that's not bad. They might hold off on casting removal until after I play the Ruckus. Oh, never mind. I thought they were going to do removal things. Sure. If that commits a crime, that gets that thing lifelink. And... Oh, so we're just going to give this Minache. There's this. We don't need the blue source yet, right? And then we are going to saddle. And I will attack with this. Okay, all right. We have the ability to give it first strike, so if they do choose to double block, it's actually a huge blowout here. Okay. I think the best use of our mana would be to play the Scalestorm Summoner. Actually, wait, hold on. If we play another Gila Courser, let's play the Scalestorm Summoner for now, because we could play the Bristlepack Sentry later in turn. Like, we could play it next turn. We have another one in our hand. I'd like to draw some more lands, by the way, deck. But leaving up mana for Great Train Heist when we attack is kind of fun, too. Yep, at knife point. Okay, so they have First Strike, which means we're not blocking here. They could activate this. Yep. I'm not dumb. I'm not blocking. You fucking crazy, man. Yeah, no blocks here. This also commits a crime for them. I mean, sorry, this commits a crime, so this actually makes a token for them. That's what I meant to say. I think we're getting too much card advantage off of this Gila Courser. Yep, that dings us. So they're going to make a token. They're going to give that lifelink, I'm assuming. Yep. Sure. I think I Savage Smash that Rattleback Apothecary now. I don't control. Oh, it's a fight. I'm so stupid. I don't know why I thought it was a fight. I'm dumb. It's okay. I think we have to play this now, don't we? Brain stupid. Why did I... I should have just killed the Vault Buster. No attacks.
No attacks.
I don't know what went on in my goddamn brain. That's a major pun. That might have cost us the game.
Oh, shit.
If anything, maybe the Bristlepack Sentry should have punched it. Yeah, Rakish Crew. Okay, so that's going to drain us out, I think. They're constantly leaving up the one mana to do the thing. I have to triple block this if I want this to matter. They get to kill one of them, and it's probably the Scalestorm Summoner. Right, yeah. Sure. I take one. I get a token. Yep. Yep. They lose an outlaw. I take another one. Not great. Play this. Play another Gila Courser. Alright, Yep. Sure, that does drain us for three, but what are you gonna do? Resolve all. And then we're going to plot this big boy. Opponent's hand is probably stacked. Skewer. Ah, good game. They could have cast that for one, too. Ah, Jesus. All right. Ah! That was entirely my fault. I'm sorry, everybody. I should have used that Savage Smash to maybe... Because I did want to get rid of that creature. So maybe... And I wanted it to make it so that it was hard for them to block. I'm so used to so many of the removal spells in this being bites instead of fights. Oh, that was a huge punt. I should have had one of my sentries kill it. Leave match. Especially because we could have gotten a little bit further into their life total, as well as exiled another card that we could have cast. Likely, because we were hitting our land drops and everything. Ah, that felt bad. That was my bad. I'm so sorry, everybody. All right, so Sentry, first time I've seen the Gardener. Free Strider Commando, sure, let's go. Yep, there's the crime. Land drop. Land is great here, actually. Gardener is the next play, right? Oh, they have counter magic. Alright, so let's play this. Let's see if they want to counter that. Oh, no, okay. That makes their Phantom Interference much worse later on. Vault Plunderer, sure. Yeah. Okay. I think we can just play this and then attack with the Sentry. I could, but I'm not going to. I'd rather just keep the board clear. Oh, we can just play that, right? Play this. Kind of pitch the commando here, see what else we get. The land, end turn. More lands with the Great Tree and Heist is actually better. Yeah, okay. So they have something in hand. Play that. Oh, you know, I probably shouldn't have played a land. Assuming ashes. Sure. Like, that does suck, but what are you gonna do, right? Maybe I should have just attacked with everything? Nah. Ooh. That's some archive trap? Yeah, that's kind of cool. Alright. That's kind of cool. Alright, so I'm gonna hold on to this forest for the time being. Alright, gem, Skyfoot Explorer. Next turn, we're gonna hold on to that. Please block. I would love to do the thing. Alright, so... end turn. Because if we get Collective Defiance, I just get to, like, empty my hand. Mm-hmm. I think opponent's blue-white splashing black? Okay. They might bury us in card advantage. We can pay for a Phantom Interference, too, if we give this first strike, right? Okay. Sure. Mm-hmm. Land, Gardener. Gain two. Yep. Should I have just played the prickly pear? Oh god, it's a Geralt. That's bad for me. That's bad. This is going poorly. Geralt is a huge problem. Especially with that. Yep. Yep. So they probably mill me because it's not bad actually. Because they don't know what they're doing. I wish they got another one of these lands. Alright, so we can't attack right now. No attacks. Play the prickly pear. And end turn. I would like a blue source and a body paw. That'd be great. Sure. Intimidation campaign. This is looking bad. This is looking bad. They got us at that control point now. We needed to out aggro them. And their board's massive now. And they've stabilized. They have the intimidation campaign. The gem Lightfoot just gets in for free every turn. This Desperate Bloodseeker, it gets to trade with whatever they want to on my board, essentially, right? Like, there's no reason to not attack with it. Alright, sure. Play Yolene. Essence Capture. Alright, I think that might be it. Next. No attacks, end turn. I think that might be it. Maybe I needed to attack first with a prickly pear pumped up with the... The thing about that is that it trades with a Desperate Bloodseeker or one of these. Yep. Alright, good game. I'm scooping of that. Let's see. Oh, God! Basically, what was it? Esper Control? Their deck was sweet, though. They had... God, I don't think I saw this many good cards at all during our draft. Assimilation, Aegis, Geralt the Fleshrite. I still don't know if Gem Lightfoot's good, right? Like, I don't. I really don't. But Geralf and Assimilation Aegis is already like enough for a deck. Leave match. Ah, what a shame. It's okay. We went 2-3. I do believe I did punt with regards to that stupid oh god, what is it called? The Apothecary, the Rattleback Apothecary. It's such a good card though, and like it was keeping them from they were at 17 that turn, right? Like it was keeping them alive, more than alive. It was keeping them healthy. We'll claim this. but you, yes, you, dear viewer, enjoyed that. Please hit that like button. And more importantly, come over to twitch.tv/dcrackered. Link in the description where you catch doing stuff like this left, right, and center. You can laugh at me while I punt in real time. Have a good evening, folks.